Universal Event Tracking, or UET, is a powerful Bing Ads tool. You just need to create a single UET tag and add it to your website once. This tag records what customers do on your website, and then Bing Ads starts to collect that data, which allows you to track conversions or target audiences with your remarketing list. Be sure to check out our other UET video on conversion tracking, but for now, let's go ahead and take a look at remarketing. It happens all the time. A potential customer visits your website, spends some time looking at a specific product, and then leaves without purchasing anything. You know he's interested. What if you could show him a customized ad for the product the next time he searches for something similar? With Bing Ads, you can. It's called remarketing, targeting people who have visited your site before. There are four steps to set up remarketing. Add a UET tag to your website, create a remarketing list, assign the list to an ad group, and optimize your campaigns for your remarketing list. The first thing that you need to do is add a UET tag on your website. This tag records what customers do on your website and sends data to Bing Ads as your customers take various actions. If you already have a UET tag set up on your website, then you're ready to go. Otherwise, you'll need to go to the tags page to create a UET tag and then copy it onto your website's code. Create remarketing lists to identify and target specific visitors to your site. Select the type of visitor and set rules that define which ones to include. For example, let's say you sell coffee. You can target people who have visited your Sumatran coffee bean page and also your French press page in the past week. Or people who have added an item to their shopping cart but did not complete the purchase. Then select an existing UET tag. Now that you've created your remarketing list, you need to associate it with an ad group. You can also do this in bulk from the ad groups tab. See help for more information. Choose bid only or target and bid. Bid only means that everyone who searches on your keywords can see your ad, but any adjustments you make will only apply to people on your remarketing list. Target and bid means that only people on your remarketing list will see the ad. On the other hand, if you're trying to prevent ads from displaying for a certain audience, you can exclude a remarketing list of those users from the ad group. For example, if you're trying to attract new customers, you could exclude people who have already visited your Sumatran coffee bean page. Finally, optimize your campaign for your remarketing list in one or more of three ways: adjust bids, customize ads, and broaden keywords. Set bid adjustments for your remarketing list in the Audiences tab. For example, for the remarketing list of people who have added coffee beans to their shopping carts but did not purchase, you can increase bids for searches on coffee. If you selected target and bid, when you associated your remarketing list to an ad group, you could also customize your ads and broaden keywords. If your remarketing list has people who visited both your Sumatran coffee bean page and your French press page, you could have a custom ad offering a combo deal on both. Try adding broad match keywords that people on your remarketing list are likely to search on. You might not usually bid on coffee as a broad match, but when it only applies to people on your remarketing list, it might be just what you need to get the ads in front of them. With remarketing, you're showing an ad for a product to people who you know are interested in that product. All you have to do is reel them back in.